This week is a time to recognize the great heroes of every homestead with National Husband's Day. So we start this week's Explore Tulsa with a perfect strike to celebrate.
Then a chapel to look through.
Followed by a floral legacy.
Plus a bugging out for the season.
Hi, I'm Stevie Fernandez.
And I'm Trish Whitmer. As always, we're excited to see you back with us for this week's Explore Tulsa.
Trish, have you ever considered becoming a professional bowler?
No.
You have the guns for it. You should try it out because the women in the PWBA don't quite have the looks you have. Plus, we could clean up an endorsement deal.
Hold on, what do you mean by we?
Well, I'd be your trainer, of course, and we'd make the Dust Bowl downtown your home lanes.
There hadn't been a bowling alley in quite some time in downtown Tulsa. We've been stationed here for the last 6 years, though, so we're bringing a little bit more fun back to the downtown area with all the recent growth. We're a part of the McNellys group, so they've been downtown and in growth for a little over a decade in the Blue Dome District. The owner felt as if they needed to have a facility with an activity as well as libations, fun for all ages. So thought, what better than to do a bowling alley in downtown in one of the vacant spots? The downtown and the growth over the last decade and a half has presented, like I said, a number of things for every walk of life to do, every age group. It's a draw now for, you know, the 20-somethings that are graduating from university and wanting a small town feel, but with activities and the possibilities. It's grown exponentially. We do see many generations coming and experiencing and having a great time, because you can really spend the full day, whether it's Guthrie Green and then coming to bowl and going out to eat. So it has a little bit of something for everybody. It's kind of a nice classic throwback to when they were growing up with their parents and their grandparents. The wood paneling and the plaid carpet and the pencil and paper scorekeeping. For the ones that don't know how to keep score or well versed in it necessarily, there are instructions on all of our score sheets, and then of course our staff is well versed and assist with the scorekeeping of the games. They come through, get drink orders, food orders, and also assist in scorekeeping. So the name came about, kind of the Dust Bowl, the throwback to the early 1900s in Oklahoma, and it just made sense. The dust definitely does come whipping down Elgin. The Tulsa location's been here for 6 years, and then the Dust Bowl in Oklahoma City's been around for a few years as well, so we're the first of hopefully many. We do have a number of families that do meet here on the weekends in the afternoon, especially when the weather might be poor outside. It gives a little bit of something extra. We do have a league night twice a week, one on Tuesday and one on Thursday. That's a co-ed optional. They come in and bowl three games a night and hang out for a few hours. There's a lot of camaraderie, a little bit of competition, but everyone has fun. I enjoy the fact that there's camaraderie, and pretty much any age group can do this. Anyone from a 2.5-year-old to an 80-year-old has bowled on these lanes, and everybody seems to enjoy the fun times that we can have here. That's a classic game with the same classic functions. We do have 6 public lanes in the lounge area, and then we do have a private room that hosts 2 lanes for a more intimate setting, 12 to 16 guests. Also has a private flat screen TV and iPod hookup, so a little bit more seclusion, a few more amenities. So it's a lot of fun for smaller birthdays and gatherings. So on top of the bowling, we do have a daily kitchen, hostings of burgers, tater tots done 7 different ways, a few vegetarian options, hummus, wraps, a few sandwiches. We also do have a full bar. So if the adults want to partake in adult libations, we can provide that as well. We are an all-ages facility until 8 p.m. and then we go 21 and over, since we're a little bit more of a bar establishment at that point. It's been a huge draw for travelers, actually making a location to come in to town and spend a long weekend. And then, like I said, the 20-somethings coming and staying and building a life here. It's been a fantastic experience so far, and I look forward to the many years to come, all the faces that we get to meet, the people, the walks of life, so, and to present a fun facility.
After seeing Erica Bowl, you might want to sit this one out and I'll become her trainer.
To get in on the fun for yourself or plan a private party, visit dustbowlok.com to learn more.
I always thought that a bowling alley would be a great place for a wedding. Pick up the spare for wedded bliss.
You are such a guy. A much more beautiful surrounding is the Glass Chapel in Broken Arrow. Our next stop when we come back with more Explore Tulsa.
Gluten-free, organic, natural, whole grain, all words used by marketers to make you believe you're buying healthy food.
Even when the product isn't necessarily good for you.
But there's an easy fix. Instead of believing what's in front of you, turn it around and read the label. Find out what's really in the product.
Our goal is to eliminate sugars, grains, and breads from our diet. Start by eliminating sugar and grains one day each week.
Each day without sugar and grains is one day closer to a healthier you.
Visit our website to find our free glycemic index food chart to learn how specific carbohydrates affect your body.
Sony and Video Revolution take you there, from space travel to world championships. Tomorrow's technology today, 4K smart TVs, and the largest flat screens available. Now, more than ever, you have the best seat in the world when history is made. Video Revolution. On the northwest corner, 71st and Lewis.
Hi, my name's Katina Perry. I'm with Harvard Meats, and you're watching Explore Tulsa.
Hi again, and welcome back for more Explore Tulsa. Stevie, where did you and your wife get married?
At the hospital. Her grandfather performed our vows as his last ceremony. And I personally recommend a hospital room. It's cozy. You don't have to get all hung up on decorations or who to invite, who not to invite. And the ice chips are free.
Oh, as special as your service was, many people prefer an atmosphere made more for formal events, like the gorgeous Glass Chapel and Broken Arrow.
It makes me feel like you understand your calling in life. That's how it makes me feel. I understand my call now, and everyone seems to think sometimes that to be a Christian or to love God means that you have to be in a pulpit or you have to be, you know, telling someone. It's just as simple as making sure that a bride and their family are comfortable and that they're having the most beautiful day of their lives here, and then the fruit of that gets to go out into the world and feed children. It gets to go out into the world and make sure that others are educated and that they don't feel displaced and that they feel loved and that they feel accepted, because everyone wants to know that they're accepted and acknowledged in this world. And so that's how it makes me feel, is to know that not only am I accepted and acknowledged in the family of Jesus Christ, but also that others can be taken care of because it is love through us. Glass Chapel for us now is more than just a wedding venue for brides to come in and be able to be married and also have the receptions. We also consider ourselves an event center for those with smaller events, for them in the community to come in and be able to enjoy private parties, fundraisers. We've thrown galas, and we just have an exceptional great time because of the use of the gardens also. So Russ and Judy Joe Adams are the owners of Glass Chapel, and what attracted them to it is essentially that they were really looking for a place to have a base for their international ministries. And their ministries are Russ Adams Ministry, which is RAM. And with that, they were looking for a place to be able to go and have their base. And when they were looking at properties, this one came up. And they had to also buy the chapel along with it, in which case we thought that was a great opportunity that God is allowing us to be able to take all of the profits over from the chapel into the ministry. And so they came about that in 2015, and we've been able to have weddings here. And what used to be the Tivoli Inn in the back of the property is now our International Headquarters and Missions House. And that's for missionaries to be able to come in that we have all over the country and internationally and be able to come in and rest and be able to have a place to be. Russ Adams Ministries has a Bible college, and that's called Explore Nations. We have Explore Nation colleges in four continents. And essentially what makes us different than others is that we started in the Middle East in Cairo, Egypt. So our first school opened in Cairo, Egypt back in 2009. That then spread over into other continents where we're looking at Honduras. We have works in Honduras. We also have works in England. Their first school opened here in Tulsa, Oklahoma for North America. And so actually we hold class here on Tuesday evenings and we're in our fourth year and we're about to have our graduates graduate. We also not only just have the schools, but we also do missions. We're not here to make money off of everyone and then take it and put it into our pockets. We really are here for the community. It's more so than just being able to take those profits and go here into the ministry and then go out into the world. We also want to do everything here at home. And so we want to be able to have a place open for the community to feel like they have somewhere beautiful to go. They can have an event here, it's gorgeous. Your staff is gonna love you. We're gonna take care of you. We wanna make sure that you're taken care of, but also it's gonna go out into the world. So you know that everything that you're gonna do here is going out into the refugee camps in France. It's going out to Syrians, it's going out to Honduras, but it's also going to those that wanna learn more. And so it goes into our schools, but we're really, really proud of the fact that this isn't for profit for us. It's really to go out into the missions field.
It's so wonderful to meet people like Victoria, passionate about her work and her contribution to the success of the Russ Adams Ministries.
To find out how to book the Glass Chapel for your next event or wedding, visit tarpchapelandgardens.com.
Next, we should check in with JP, see if he ever sets up the Glass Chapel with any of Mrs. DeHaven's flowers.
That's coming up next with more Explore Tulsa.
Hello, I'm John Erling with Voices of Oklahoma. Our great state has been home to countless individuals whose place in history has been earned through each of their many accomplishments. Voices of Oklahoma's mission is to preserve their story in an oral history presentation like none other. Accounts direct from famous Oklahomans, political figures, and many others who have left their indelible mark on the development, history, and future of Oklahoma. So please, treat yourself by listening to those who are the Voices of Oklahoma.
Hi, Dr. Robert Zellner here. For over 20 years, I've offered affordable, convenient eye care in Tulsa. Right now, you can get one pair of glasses or contact lenses starting at just $99 or my two-pair deal for $129. Hey, and as always, the eye exam's included. Walk-ins are always welcome. Glasses are ready in about an hour. Plus, we have over 2,000 frames to choose from. We're open 7 days a week. Come see why we're voted Tulsa's best. And our drive-thru at 69th and Memorial makes pickup simple and easy. For the best eye care value in Tulsa, Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates.
Hi, Tuck Curran from Big Italian Restaurant. I'm the chef owner here, and you're watching Explore Tulsa.
If you enjoy a little bit of history, then you'll be so glad you stuck around for more Explore Tulsa.
That's right, Stevie, because we're going back 112 years ago to the year 1905 when Mrs. DeHaven's flower shop first opened for Tulsans to enjoy.
What a great year. In November of 1905, Robert Galbraith and Frank Chesley struck oil in Glenpool.
I bet someone bought a lot of flowers for Mrs. DeHaven's on that day.
DeHaven's has been open since 1905. We were actually the original member of the Chamber of Commerce for Tulsa, which is pretty cool. We were in this location, we've been in this location for a really, really long time. And DeHaven's was around originally when it was still Indian Territory, you know. And so we've been in Tulsa, we've supported Tulsa, and Tulsa has supported us since 1905. So it's been great. Obviously, I have not been around since 1905. That or I've just aged really well. Who knows, who could have walked in these doors over the years, whether it be presidents, whether it be famous movie stars, actors, actresses, athletes, you never know. It'd be cool, if these walls could talk, then I'm sure they would tell some pretty crazy stories about what's gone on here over the years. There's so much history. Josephine DeHaven had it and originally started it, and then it went to Trula Austin, and then to Jerry Parkhurst, and who I bought it from then after that. So Jerry had it a long time, and so I bought both Mrs. DeHaven's and the Gadget Company from him at the same time. And it was pretty cool because he actually took over Mrs. DeHaven's when he was 23, and then I bought it from him when I was 23. And we both have JP as our initials, so it was pretty interesting. I think that's what's helped them stay around for so long, was really realizing that if you're not good to your customers, they're not gonna be good to you in return. And I think customer service has been key to them and their success. So this part of town I really like because we have so much traffic that drives by us every single day. Everyone who is leaving downtown or wants to go downtown or heading to Cherry Street, they drive right by us right in the corner. This area is becoming so much more residential, a lot of families moving in here. I just think it's a great area that people want to be in, and we have so many other great restaurants and shops on our street that I think it's very attractive for our customer base to want to come down here. Pretty much all of our arrangements are custom made, so it's by the order. We want you to get exactly what you want, whether for whatever occasion or for whoever it is. We want it to be custom and tailored to you and to your liking. They don't let me come too close to making any of the arrangements. They say we want to actually sell the product, JP. We don't want to have to give it away. So they try and keep me away from there, and I'm very fortunate that I have them to handle all that. Well, we've done a lot of weddings over the past, and we're doing some weddings now, and we really enjoy doing those because we get to experience the joy that comes with a wedding and be there for the bride and the groom and the families on that special day, because we want to take all the stress out of it. Flowers are the last thing you should have to worry about on your wedding day. We want to try and make that as easy and as simple as possible. And seeing the look on the bride's faces when everything, you know, goes the way it's supposed to is really rewarding, I think. The responsibility that I feel is I've taken over a historic mark in Tulsa. I mean, everybody knows Mrs. DeHaven's. I mean, it's been around forever, like we were saying. And you never want to be that person who lets that legacy kind of fall off to the side. I just want to help carry it and bring it into the newer generation and keep modernizing it and changing it with the times so that we can keep getting new customers and a different customer base, but while still maintaining the same customers that have supported us for years and years.
I tell you, that JP is quite the young entrepreneur, and he's doing an amazing job keeping Mrs. DeHaven's legacy alive.
To learn more for yourself or get a special arrangement for someone wonderful in your life, visit MrsDeHavens.com.
Ay, 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 I'm the mosquito bandito.
What are you doing?
I'm coming up with a theme song for our next guest.
I don't think Kyle needs a jingle, but I guess we'll ask him when we return with more Explore Tulsa. Why are we in spacesuits?
We are traveling to the future, where TVs have a contrast range between 400 nits of brighter whites and blacks as deep as 0.4 nits.
Oh,
and
yeah.
10-bit color gives us over a billion individual colors on the screen.
Video Revolution already has tomorrow's TVs today with the best in Sony high dynamic range TVs.
TVs with contrast and color offering more natural, true-to-life colors?
Oh, yes. Video Revolution now and in the future on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
Like, parents have a thing, when it gets too quiet in the home, we're worried, you know what I mean? I don't like silence in the home because it just feels dead.
Silence, that just doesn't feel like a creative place to me.
Turning on music in your house is almost like turning on the lights in your house.
Music makes mundane stuff better. And it's never too late to discover new things.
You just never know what song's gonna come on next.
Silence is probably the enemy of a happy home.
Come here for yourself at Video Revolution.
Hi, I'm Donna Breuer with Donna's Fashions here in Tulsa. And you're watching Explore Tulsa.
Hello, great to see you still with us for more Explore Tulsa. You know, Trish, I love this time of year, getting out in the yard and just chilling out, but those darn mosquitoes are such a problem at my place.
What you need is to call on the Mosquito Bandito.
Ooh, he sounds like a bad hombre.
Well, he is if you're a mosquito.
Just kind of searching for different fun ways for people to remember who we are, and Mosquito Bandito was something that wasn't taken, which is the key, and sounded fun. When you see it, you're gonna remember it. Out of high school, I went into the Coast Guard. I wanted something to serve and kind of figure out what I wanted to do with myself and the Coast Guard. I love the water, love the ocean. I thought it'd be a great opportunity to get out and explore some and as well as help, and it was very exciting. Yeah, when I got out, my dad was a painter, had a painting business, and I worked for him for a bit, and then decided I didn't like getting yelled at too much and having to clean up all the messes, so I went in and started my own, and always had painting in the background, and when an opportunity arose, I always tried to do something different. I learned about this, my dad was visiting friends in Mississippi, and up on the Gulf, he was in his front yard having a sitting outside visiting, and they went on a walk through the neighborhood to walk the dogs and got ate with mosquitoes. When he went back, there was no mosquitoes, and the guy told him about it, and my dad called me up and told me about it and thought it might be another opportunity. We do have a lot of mosquito issues in Oklahoma, not only, you know, the pests that they are, but also the diseases they can carry. In the U.S., we have about 175 different mosquito varieties. Of those, we've got about 60 in Oklahoma. So there is a lot out there. We have mosquitoes that primarily bite in the morning, some that in daytime, and some that don't like the sun at all that come out just at night. So they get us all times of the day and evening. The mosquito trucks, they kind of go through and they're kind of treat the larva, and the air is a standing water in the trees. They do kill it some, but what we do is we come out and we are going to treat your yard, your space, and we're going to guarantee that. So we're going to kill the mosquitoes, then we're going to guarantee you're not going to have any for the next 21 days. The chemicals that I use, they're not necessarily harmful. I mean, we recommend that, you know, pets and children, you know, stay inside while we spray. But when we come out, we treat your area, and it's not going to be anything that's harmful to pets or children. As soon as we're done spraying, it dries relatively fast, and, you know, pets and children are great to come back outside in the mosquito-free environment. Key to managing mosquitoes is keeping your area clean from the mosquito harboring areas. Pots, you know, you have your planted pots that have the little container underneath there, keeping the water out of them. If you have bird baths, you know, it's great for the birds, but not for the mosquitoes. In the summer months, it's good to keep those empty. Anywhere there's standing water, you try to eliminate that. Doesn't matter if your neighbors aren't getting a mosquito treatment done on their house, you don't have anything to worry about. I create a barrier around your property so that you don't have anything to worry about. I'm gonna keep their mosquitoes out of your yard. Our mosquito season in Oklahoma generally runs mid-April through mid-October. I start my service in mid-April, around April 15th is the time we start. It runs every 21 days. A person can start at any time. A lot of people start about Memorial Day whenever they start to hang outside a little more for the summertime. When I started, the customers were some people are a little iffy, and, you know, when I come back for the second treatment, they're just astounded. They just can't believe that something actually worked to keep the mosquitoes out of their yard. It's great having your own business for the freedom. As far as a lot of the customers, whenever you go and you go back to return the service, it's great because they're spending more time outside with their family in the evening. They cook out more. Their pets are safer as well outside. Everyone just has a better, we buy our homes, a lot of them, our patios, to enjoy the outside. And it's nice to be able to enjoy it through the summer in the evening times as well.
Kyle has such a great radio voice, and I can't wait to get rid of all those pesky mosquitoes in my backyard.
To find out how to make your yard mosquito-free, visit MosquitoBanditoOK.com to schedule an appointment.
Yeah, just make sure you don't accidentally look up Mosquito Bandito, the one-man punk rock band.
I'm not believing you on that.
He's right there on MySpace. His music will probably chase away mosquitoes and everyone you know, too.
Stick around. There's more Explore Tulsa just ahead.
Take charge of your health. We are what we put into our bodies.
We approach medicine from a unique standpoint. Rather than treating only the symptoms of an illness, we work to find the root cause and promote wellness of the entire body.
Our clinic offers complete assessment and treatment programs, including hormone replacement therapy, osteopathic manipulative therapy, and genetic DNA testing. It all starts with a medical evaluation.
Contact us today to begin your path to wellness.
Hey, it's Stevie from Explore Tulsa with my friend and optometrist for many years, Dr. Robert Zellner. Tell everybody why it's so good to come in to see you.
Well, that's a great question. Let's see, we've got two great locations. We try to stay cutting edge at every point along the way because let's face it, everybody wants to come in and get taken care of in a timely fashion and get the latest, greatest stuff and save some money and get on with their life and see clearly.
And if you don't believe it, look on the website.
Absolutely, drzellner.com. You can find that we have our two locations at 69th and Memorial and 3030 South Harvard, or you can give us a call at 749-2020 or 461-2020.
And I got four kids, and I got to tell you, as a big family like that, it's affordable too.
Oh yes, and of course, the number one reason, you save some money. I mean, with our two pair specials, with our different unique packages that we put together, I mean, you can come in here and your money can go a lot farther than anywhere else.
And that's why, with Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates, seeing is believing.
Oh, I like that, yeah. Stevie. Well done.
Hi, I'm Victoria McCarter, co-founder of the Mused Organization. We're Tulsa's new poetry and collaborative arts nonprofit, and you're watching Explore Tulsa.
Be sure to join us next week when we see what's playing at the upcoming University of Tulsa Senior Film Festival.
Special thanks to Erica Estes and everyone having fun at the Dust Bowl downtown.
But thanks too to Victoria Mars for sharing the story of the Glass Chapel with us. And thanks to J.P. Hewitt for keeping history alive at Mrs. DeHaven's Flower Shop.
Also thanks to Kyle Birch for keeping our homes mosquito free.
Remember, if you miss any of the show, you can always catch us at ExploreTulsa.com.
As always, each week we feature the people, places, and attractions that make us proud to call Tulsa our home.
And hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook and share with us someone you think Tulsa should know more about.
Plus, remember, Explore Tulsa is brought to you by Video Revolution, located on the northwest corner of 71st and Lewis.
Stop by, say hello to Ron and all the guys for all your home entertainment needs.
And Explore Tulsa is also proudly brought to you by Dr. Robert Zellner and Associates.
Home of Tulsa's best eye care value with two locations, 3030 South Harvard and 69th and Memorial.
And we welcome our newest sponsors, Dr. Mark and Michelle Sherwood at 61st and Sheridan.
Remember, your journey to whole body healing and wellness begins with the Functional Medical Institute.
Well, that's all the time we have for you on this week's show, but we'll see you next week right here on Explore Tulsa.